Coco, amigos, estamos en Ultimate Source, que es una compañía que finalmente esta es la que vende, pero realmente son los escultores de muchas figuras de acción que conocemos, y aquí está Chris para hablarnos. Hi, Chris.
Hi, how are you?
Very well. Now, you were telling me that you're sculpting for some other brands.
Yes.
As well.
Yeah, absolutely. So we've been very fortunate. We've moved into digital sculpting, I think 16, 17 years ago. We were one of the first companies to do digital sculpting. And while traditional sculpting is really fantastic, digital sculpting is really the future. You can make changes super fast on the fly. You can go from a sculpt concept on your computer to rapid prototype in like 12 hours. It's really fantastic.
What is the process of digital sculpting? In comparison versus the traditional sculpting?
Well, with traditional sculpting, you know, it's very detailed. It's very time consuming from that standpoint. Using a wax is really great from that, and you could get really nice detail. But let's say you have it and you finished a wax sculpt, and then the client says, well, that's great. I want you to make it 10% bigger. 10% bigger means you have to start completely over. Now, digital, 10% means it's just a couple of hours of work on the computer to actually scale it up. As from wax, you have to start that process completely over, and it can take you several days. And that's really where the industry is moving to, is from digital sculpting from that standpoint. It's much easier to transfer files over when you go to real prototyping and real masking and molding it out and going right from that digital sculpt to tooling. So you save a lot of time in the process.
You were doing the Activision game Skylanders.
Yes, yes. So we've been very fortunate working with Skylanders from day one, from the original concept of the game. And Activision was great working with us as far as working on the models itself and the actual design of the characters, making sure that every character they design is toolable and moddable as well, so they can actually get them into production. We've been really fantastic working with them on 6 years in a row on all the different Skylanders. I think we've sculpted and developed over 250 of the characters in the games for all the versions of the game. So it's been a fantastic process with that.
And you have your line of your own, which is Monsters 500.
Monsters 500 is a line that we had out a few years ago with Toys R Us. It did really well, but what we've done was we retooled it. We changed some of the paint. We revised the packaging. You know, and the sculpts on these are really fantastic for the price point that you're going to be getting at.
Yeah, and we can see here. Bueno, aquí podemos ver parte del trabajo de escultura, de cómo van siendo los modelos al producto terminado.
So, yeah, so what we're showing here is we're showing several different stages of our sculpting ability. We're showing it as early rapid prototypes without any paint deco, and then we're showing first prototypes with the first round of paint deco on them. From there, we'll look at it, we'll make changes, make sure it's moldable from that standpoint, and actually if we can combine stuff in the tools, let's try to save on costing and make the process of developing much faster. But the range that we're showing here is we're showing a vast thing of highly detailed figures, figures that have articulation, other figures that are just static figures but show them in a very aggressive and fun pose, and we're even showing some figures that have electronics in them as well. So the variety that Ultimate Source can do from concept all the way from production is really fantastic in all aspects of making making products.
And now you have other product.
Yes.
That it is quite a no-brainer, but it really needs to get some imagination on it, which is 8-bit art.
8-bit art has been a love passion project for me for many years. So I've been a big fan of taking post-it notes and making my favorite characters on walls and windows into my office. But the process of trying to do it on your own is kind of hard and very time consuming. You have to first go online and find a grid image of the character you like. Then you have to go to the store and hope they have all the colors that you need for all the post-it notes. Then I can't tell you a number of times I'll start to make a figure on a wall, a character, and run out of space. So what we did was we actually made it much easier and created custom kits. So right away you're gonna get an image of the character and know exactly what you're gonna make. You get all the custom colors and all the post notes needed, and then we include an adhesive ruler so you know exactly the location that you're gonna put it on, your window, your door, your dorm room, and so forth. So we make it not only much easier and a great affordable price point. So these are gonna be retailing for $4.99. We're super excited that we're partnering with Nintendo. So we have Super Mario Brothers 1, 2, and 3, Legend of Zelda, Donkey Kong, and then we're going to be branching off into holiday lines. So we have Christmas, we have Halloween, and we have Valentine's Day.
Yeah, and puedo mostrarles aquí
cómo viene. O sea, son los pequeños post-its. Y aquí están las instrucciones de cómo ensamblar a tu Mario.
It's a Mario.
Well, it's quite interesting what you already have here. And for last, you were telling us that you were sculpting this for Revell.
Yes. So we partnered with Revell last year, and the first product lines we did with them was Episode 7, Star Wars. And you can see these are showing just the early rapid prototype samples that we made. We have the X-Wing, the TIE Fighter, and the Millennium Falcon. We're branching out much more with Revell for 2017 and 2018 beyond. So we have doing multiple programs with them, which continues with Star Wars. But right now, the latest ones that we did with them was for Rogue One, that you can find at retail. So they're really fantastic. Really great model kits.
Pues este es uno de los descubrimientos que hemos hecho aquí en Toy Fair. No solamente conocer a los que los venden, sino también a quienes están creando y desarrollando las esculturas que ustedes pueden al final comprar con los distintos productores, vendedores allá en donde los podamos comprar, ¿no? Desde Activision hasta Revell y, bueno, las líneas propias. Ha sido algo muy interesante. It has been a pleasure, Chris, being here and getting you explaining all of this.
Absolutely, no problem. Thanks for coming by.
Continuamos estos juegos, juguetes y coleccionables.